We're back, and we're here with Ashley Borden, and she's here talking to women about the advantages of lifting weights, not bulking up, which is the myth. We're going to get to it in just a little bit. But before we do that, last week there was so much talk about the Biggest Loser and the finale and all the weight loss that the winner walked away without.
Right.
As a fitness professional, what was your take on that?
Well, I think I also want to clarify that I'm also a recovering person with 22 years of recovery from every eating disorder you can imagine. So looking at this, when I was looking at it, I thought it was interesting that people were so taken aback, because I was not surprised at all that she looked the way she did, because she was an athlete before.
Sure.
And a lot of times when you're an athlete and you've lost it, and then she kind of got back into it, she kind of tapped back into the athlete mentality. But I think that the thing was looking at the way she looked, the comparison was more shocking than it was.
Yeah, but Ashley, truth be told, this woman lost almost 60% of her body weight.
Right, which is great. But you know what? We were talking earlier before. I think that people, it's so interesting, they're so concerned about her at where she is right now, but less concerned and more judgmental about somebody who's overweight. And I really see that a lot as a fitness professional. I mean, personally, if you were to see her at a coffee shop, I don't think very many people would be, oh my gosh, she looks horrendous. I mean, we don't know what's going on the inside.
Sure.
We don't really know what her lean mass is. We don't know what her body fat is. We know that she, you know, what she said, that she was 5'4", 105 pounds. So she might have been on the lighter side, but
but looking at her from a mom's point of view, from my daughter, when she's that weight, I'd be concerned for her health issues, diabetes, heart. And then if she got that thin, I would be concerned because she's so thin. And then again, your period stopped. And it's a whole other health issue.
But we don't know.
So we don't know
if that's the case with her. We don't know if her period stopped. We don't know, because that's, again, you know, this is all just looking at a photo. Also, something else I do see a lot is that this was her big reveal day.
Yeah.
So we don't know where she is now, what she's maintaining. You know, my concern is also is the psychological thing behind these big transformations.
Right.
You don't get this big without having some kind of issue that got you there in the first place. And if you don't take care of what's on the inside with this, it will flip-flop into something else. I'm not saying that's the deal with her, but, you know, I think it's interesting that the people are more concerned with somebody who's thin and a lot more judgmental with somebody who's overweight.
This is all led, by the way, and I'll put a button on this. This is all led to the producers of the show, The Biggest Loser, reevaluating what they consider the winner to be and taking a look at their show. Let's move on,
though.
New hashtag out now that's called Strong is the New Skinny.
Yes, I love it.
Why?
I love it.
Why?
I must be really thin because I'm very strong.
You are very strong.
What is that message about?
Well, I think the message is that it doesn't even necessarily matter what you look like. It's how strong are you in capability. Like, are you able to lift something up from the floor and put it away above your head, like on an airplane? I think that being strong means a lot of things. You can look leaner, you look more muscular, or you're just, again, like I said, more capable. Skinny, to me, is very 80s to be skinny. And skinny can also mean, so last season. And skinny is, it all really has to do with what's going on with your strength and what's going on with your muscle mass. So women are very afraid of weights. A lot of women are afraid
of weights.
Because
we're afraid of bulking.
Yeah, why don't you take us through some exercises and you can debunk the myth about
bulking up. I want to show you guys, this is a great circuit that you can do in a small space. And what you do is you just keep on moving through the circuit. That becomes cardiovascular, and it's also building strength. So we're going to do upper and lower body. I'm going to show you guys three moves that you can do at home, and you can use weight or you can use some water bottles if you don't have weights.
Okay.
First thing we're going to do is a reverse lunge.
I'm not going to do the lunges because of my knee, but
absolutely.
I'm going to watch.
So a reverse lunge is really good for somebody with bad knees or somebody who has an issue, because forward lunging is a lot more difficult.
Yes, she said that. So good for me with bad knees?
Well, because if you're doing it correctly, so that's what's important. So you want to take a step back. When my knee is slightly kissing the floor, my weight is in my front heel, and then I'm driving up and I'm squeezing my booty at the top. So you take a step back, your weight's in your front heel, and you come up to the top.
Now, what does that do? What muscles does it work in front?
So that is working. That is working your glutes. It's working your hamstrings. It's also working your core, because you're holding the weights up here, so it's more of a challenge on your core. Then you would move to an overhead press. So again, you're standing, you're bracing your core, and you're pushing straight up over your head, maintaining that core and your glutes, and then bringing it back down, okay? And again, you're gonna push straight up, strong arms, and bring it back down.
And Ashley, what's a good starting weight for somebody? We have 10s here, but.
Well, I'm using,
I have 15.
She has 20s. Well, that's a good question. A good weight for you to find for yourself is, on a scale from 1 to 10, you want to find a weight that feels like a 7, 8 for you. So again, we would be doing 10 repetitions of everything, and the weight needs to feel challenging enough that you feel slightly cardiovascular when you're doing it.
After those 7 to 8 reps.
After 10 reps. Last move is going to be a, for your back, it's going to be a row. So you're going to sit back in your heels. You're going to pull straight back, squeeze your shoulder blades, keep your core in, and then bring it down. And again, you're going to bring, squeeze your shoulder blades, and then bringing it down. And again, super important that you're working your back for posture and muscles so you're upright. Nice, Mark. Nice.
So kind of like I'm a downhill skier.
Yes, exactly.
I'm in the Olympics. Again, Soji, here I come.
Like this. Exactly. Skiing. But again, it's important that when you're doing something like this, like we were talking before about, is it cardiovascular? You want to keep yourself moving through this circuit. You could do it for 5 minutes. Just slowly moving through this. You'll feel winded. You'll feel like you're burning calories, and your post-calorie burn will be better than if you're doing something with super lightweight and you're doing high repetitions. So it's important that women are, look at how easy this is for you. Look at her, she's like, what?
Yeah, but we just ate all that food from Fabio, so. Yeah,
we carb-loaded before.
Did you say this, debunk the myth that you will bulk up? Because I cannot.
I have been a trainer for 22 years,
and look at that body.
And look at my body. And I lift heavy. I lift very heavy. But Fred, so do you.
Actually, I've been trying to bulk up. I lift weights like crazy, and my arms are pathetically thin.
But it's a very good point, because women who stay away from heavier weight, these are the benefits of heavier weightlifting. A, we get a hormone release when we lift heavy enough, right? Heavy enough meaning that you're doing 10 repetitions and you're winded after the 10 repetitions
What's that you're doing. What do you lift? What do you lift? How many pounds?
It depends on what the move is. Yeah, it depends on what the move. I mean, for me, like, let's say I'm pushing overhead and I'm doing 30 pounds, and that's hard for me.
Yeah.
And let's say for you, 8 pounds, it doesn't matter. You're not comparing yourself to your friend. You're going on what feels.
So the hormone release.
Hormone release, very important. It releases testosterone. It releases growth hormone. Bone density. You need to have strong bones in order to prevent osteoporosis. You cannot do that with light weight. And also your post-calorie burn.
Yeah.
When you do these kind of workouts, your post-calorie burn is so much higher than when you're doing low weight, high repetition.
When you say post, after the workout.
After the workout,
so exactly. While you're at rest, you still burn.
So that is still burning. Exactly. So just, you want to do it with good form. You want to make sure that you find challenging weight. But again, you want to do what feels right for you.
There's so much information.
You know what feels right?
What?
We're going to go into the kitchen to have dessert now.
More information on Ashley, go to ashleyborden.com, and she has a bunch of stuff there. Tips and everything on our Facebook page. Losing weight is never easy unless Ashley says so. It's easy.
And I'm saying that you could do tips that make it a lot easier. And here is a very valuable tip. Get off of the soda. If you eliminate soda, 100%, you will immediately feel the waistline go down, your energy level will be different, much higher, and you'll feel de-bloated. And a lot of people don't realize how bloated they are from the sodium in it, from the fizz in it.
Chemicals.
And the chemicals, mm-hmm. Exactly. So mm-hmm. I would say the only liquid that you drink is the herbal tea and water. That will make a huge difference.
Right. To Kim Douglas.
Oh my gosh. Can I ask a question?
Yes.
Seriously, for people that, because of the fizz, they like the fizz.
Yes.
What about those soda machines that you can put the regular water in it and makes it bubbly, and then you add fresh juice, a little bit of fresh juice to it?
A little fizz isn't bad, and it's a good question because a lot of times it's really the feeling in the mouth what you're drinking.
Yeah, the bubblies.
But sometimes the bubbly can make you gassy and bloated.
I want to take just a second quickly. I know, Sophie, you have something about it. I don't know if we can get to it, but Marissa Fernandez, who's a daughter of our video operator, Rosie, we want to say is recovering from surgery. She's a senior at Johns Hopkins University. We send out our love and our prayers for her.
Yes.
Recovery. She has a promising future, and we wish her all the best. We wish you the best. We want you to come back. She's right back here tomorrow. I will be Tanner.